2 years ago, the Baylor Bears celebrated their first Heisman winner. Last year, they defeated the number one team in the country for the first time ever. So what will they do for a hat trick in 2013? To discuss the mojo in Waco, we're joined by Pete Futak. And Pete, the Bears started the year last season rough, 3-4, got it together, finished 8-5, an impressive win, as we talked about, over then number one K-State, and then also a bowl win over UCLA. Yep. They're going to pick up where they left off?
They might. I mean, the Art Briles system works. I mean, what's going on in Houston and what Kevin Sumlin took to Texas A&M, that was all started by Art Briles. He made RG3 into a superstar pro prospect. I mean, obviously the guy's a talent, but he was able to make him rise up. He did a great job with Nick Florence last year. I think he's going to do even more with Bryce Petty this season. They got a great running game. They got lots of weapons in place. In the Big 12, it's all about can you hang around in shootouts, and Baylor can absolutely do that.
All right, so you mentioned obviously no RG3, no Nick Florence, and you touched on Bryce Petty. Yep. He's the junior that's going to be the quarterback. First year, though, as a starter, so how much will Art Briles lean on that running game to kind of give him a little break there with C. Strunk and Martin there in the back?
Oh, they've got to lean on it because the running game's fantastic. The Thunder and Lightning Tambo, Glasgow Martin is going to bring the power. Like C. Strunk is my sleeper for the Heisman. I think he's going to put up just ridiculous numbers in this attack. Phenomenal over the second half of last season. You know, Bryce Petty's kind of in between. He's not as talented as RG3. He's better than Nick Florence. He's a taller, more pure passer. He's not going to run like those two guys did, but he can play. But as long as everything else is working on that ground game, that passing game is going to rise up. He's just fine.
A powerful offense, yep. I think, helped overlook some deficiencies at Floyd Casey Stadium. Yeah, we're talking defense specifically. They do have 7 starters back.
They're going to be fine. I mean, they're not great. Baylor just does not play defense. They're just not that good at it. They win games in shootouts. And there's going to be times when everything clicks, where like that K-State game of last year where the offense, everything's going to start to work and the defense is going to rise up and be part of the moment. But there are going to be other times where that defense is going to give up points in bunches. The West Virginia game, everyone wanted to give Geno Smith the Heisman last year because it beat up the worst defense in college football. The D is not going to be great, but that offense, again, is going to make up for it. They're going to win lots and lots of fun shootouts.
I don't think they'll start 3-4 this year, especially when you look at the schedule. Yep. 5 of the first 6 games are at home, plus they've got Oklahoma and Texas coming to Waco later in the season. So prediction time for them.
I think they can go 8-4. 8-4 is the high side. I think they might lose at Kansas State early on. If they win that game, though, like you said, Oklahoma games at home, I think that's going to be one of those upsets that they come up with. I think they lose at TCU. I think they lose at Texas. And I think they lose to Texas. And I think they lose at Oklahoma State. So 8-4, another great season, onto a bowl game again. That's for Baylor. Remember, this is a program that couldn't win a Big 12 game not all that long ago. And now bowl games are just kind of part of the puzzle at this
They've
point.
They've got it going and look forward to see them this season. All right, Pete, thanks very much for an overall picture of the Big 12 in 2013 and individual team breakdowns in word and in pictures. Keep it here to campusinsiders.com.